Hey, Bat Buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsy One here.
Special request,
cake textures.
Meet you at the table.
Now, y'all know I'd be fine just wearing this forever, but the world has changed. Let's talk about some of those changes as they relate to capes. All right, so we now have latex, not fabric. Everybody wants the latex. Let's take a look at a few examples.
So this is the actual texture on an 89 cape. It's very subtle.
This is one of my more extreme cape textures.
There's what a fabric cape looks like.
There's what a vinyl cape looks like.
A dusty one with foam all over it.
There's one I made myself with parachute cords and sheets, and just hand doing it.
Here's the texture on a latex cape that I do today that's done from a stunt cape from the movie.
Here's the texture that I do on my super strong capes. It's very subtle.
Here's the texture of a satin cape that my wife made for me.
And a fabric cape that I have in my collection.
There's the most extreme texture I've got, trying to go for that industrial look on the inside of the DOJ cape.
And this is what a textured cape might look like if you shine it up a little bit by using Plasti-Dip spray.
Okay, let's go up top and talk about how some of these things can be achieved. Now, I'm doing latex that takes at least a day to cure when it's not too thick, so I'm not going to be able to show you the whole thing today.
Let's say that this is a cape. What you can do is you can brush, once you have the initial coat on there, some kind of thickened up latex, and you can get some rough surfaces like that. But they'll tend to want to dry down a little bit. You'll have to do it several times. Steel wool and all kinds of other things. This is not cured enough. But you can see how by just doing the steel wool, now I'm getting a different effect than I was with the brush, okay? You might have to do this several times because when you go texture over texture over texture, you can build that texture up. Now, when this starts to cure, you'll get different effects. If I were to do this now, it wouldn't matter. And I'm not gonna go and do a long video here. I'm just talking you through this. So you can just go ahead and get something like an old rotten orange or some leather, and you can make like a texture stamp. Now, the actual cape, the way the actual cape was done is you had this really craggy leather or vinyl in 8 panels laid out. And when you forced the latex down in and the wool and everything, you had an opposite effect when you took that off. And that's the exact texture. So in order to do that exact texture, you'd have to have the exact piece. And this is 25 years old. I don't know if they're still making it. I should go down to the fabric district someday. I've been wanting to do this, but there's just not enough people asking me for capes of this nature, so I haven't done it. But basically, as this is starting to set up, you can't do it now, but you can pull away a little bit. This is really the wrong way to show you. This is made to do clay. But what I'm trying to say is just, if this was more set up, more cured, and you went and you put like this rough texture along, you went like this over and over again, what you would do is you'd force it down in there. You'd have to get it where it's not wet. You'd have to get it where it's actually forcing a thicker amount of latex aside and it would leave an impression in it. You can make this thicker before you start putting it on, which I don't have time to do right now. You can try different things. Do a whole bunch of things like this. This is way too premature to do this. I'd have to come back in a couple hours and I got other things I gotta do tonight. I like to keep really craggy pieces of leather around, okay? Really craggy, okay? You can make texture stamps out of this and force it down into the latex or whatever surface you use. So I've got some really, really almost dry latex. Let's try that and see what the difference is. Look at that, stands up like that, okay? This really, really thick stuff. I'm gonna put it on really thick just to make my point right now. It's ridiculously thick. Look at those little mountains on there. Okay, just to show you what I'm talking about. Maybe some brush strokes through there. Whatever you think, do it the way you think. What would you like to see? Yeah. Seeing the inside of the Dawn of Justice cape, what they did was they took like a great big trowel, you know, like they would do like cement for underneath tiles. They let it start setting up almost like what you do for knockdown on a drywall. They let it start setting up. So I can't demonstrate this properly right now, but what they do is they let it start setting up and then they start going like this. And all the little raised areas start having smoother parts. If you've ever seen a drywall person work, that's what I'm talking you through here. I'm not actually demonstrating this here. This is definitely not the way to do it, but I'm talking you through because I don't have time to do the whole work job right now. Maybe break up wherever you don't like what happened. Before you know it, you got another texture. And just keep doing this all day long. If you did it with some type of paint that isn't gonna flex, that's gonna be tricky. You almost have to do it with latex. You could probably do it with urethane, but I'm gonna call this done for right now because I wanna move on to some other things I gotta do here.
So I'm just trying to give you some ideas. This is what it looks like the next day when it's cured fully.
What I've done also before is just take an entire leather cape. I had to sew it and all that stuff, and you'd have the type of leather that you would want. I know, most people don't have those suppliers in their towns. So that's one thing about LA and New York and such like that you can have other choices. But, you know, just talking about textures, what I would say is do what I do. Just sit here. Say, what do I think will work? Just try different things. Do little tests. And I would let this go overnight, cure, try again. You know, have like a whole bunch of little fabric samples. Or I could do it right on the table here if I wanted to. Just have a whole bunch of things. I tried this, 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 I tried this. Different things you put together the next day. Say, okay, I want to put this one with this, put this one with this. And then give it 2 days or 3 days and see what happens. And then when you get what you like, voila! Do it on the whole cape. And you've got a textured cape. A number of times I've mounted a cowl to the cape. And when you have it mounted, you could go and do this technique right up onto the bottom of the cowl and onto the cape, blend the two, and then I would recommend plasti-dipping the whole thing afterwards once you have the texture achieved. Or stick with the classics. Hey, save yourself all the trouble, and the classics always work. Just promise me one thing, Bat Buddies. Don't do the Bat-Toosie. Or surf. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1.